Hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy, Sim Gamer, and I'm back with some more Monster Super League. Hey, I know I haven't made any videos in like, what, 2 days, 3 days? What I've been doing, I know Heroes Festival's coming, so I was like, man, I need to farm up as much Astral Gems as possible, and I didn't want to bore y'all with some Astral Gem videos, unless y'all want to know how to farm up Astral Gems. I think a lot of people don't cover that, but if for some reason, if you don't and you want me to do it, let me know, but I got up to 2,922. 78 more will get me at least 5-10 plus ones for the Heroes Festival. But other than that, that's all I've been doing. And I think what, tomorrow maybe Heroes Festival is coming. So let's go ahead and go over Verd. Okay, that's one of the other new monsters. I think I already went over the Shinobis. So let's check out the Verd here. All right. That's gonna be one of the, gonna replace the Thor as the Hero Festival Rebirth. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and look at the fire one first. We're just gonna go through all the elements, and then I'll choose which ones I think is the best ones. Alright, so Verd right here is a balance type. We go look at the Evo 3. I think everybody's gonna be able to at least Evo 3 one thing, right? So definitely if you could do a lot of 10 plus ones, and hopefully you get lucky and get a lot of 4 stars that you don't need, that you could fodder. All right, so let's look at Verd here. Max 6 star. All right, so she's a balance type, HP 27,000. I really like 30,000 plus, but it is a balance type, so it's not a tank or anything. Attack 2,500, defense 2,500, so about the same. In recovery, nobody really cares, I don't think, but 2,300. All right, so let's see what she has though, what she has going on. All right, blind, I don't know, I'm not really a huge fan of blind. I think it's probably good for Titans. All right, and her active skill is Courageous Strike. All right, so 70% chance to blind enemy for 2 turns, which stops the critical hits or reduces critical hits. It'd be even better if it just altogether stopped the critical hits, but it reduces it. And then we have the Courageous Strike here. Additional attack power proportional to the target's max HP. So that's good for also golems. And could be good for golems B10. B10, yeah. Could be good for golems B10, but mostly you're going to use them in the clan battles. Increases the variant skill, increases the allies' attack power by 30 to 35%. So that's really good. If you have an attack team, you want to bring her in. But I don't really see her being too much of a support other than having a chance to reduce the critical rate. So not a big fan of this one. But let's go ahead and look at variant skill. Not a big difference. Always goes kind of this little purple fuchsia color. I don't know. All right, so let's go to the next one. The first one was underwhelming. All right, I don't know. I don't think I would ever Evo 3 that one. All right, so let's look at the water Verd. Her name is Druidess. All right. Whoops. All right. Okay, so she's balanced, but see, her HP is over 30,000. So far, so good. I like this. HP 32,000. Her attack is a little bit under the other one at 20. So it's about 2,500. I don't know why they did the fire one like that. It's like, I don't know why. Fire one is really looking really bad right now to me. And then the defense is around 2,500 again, and recovery is way low. But nobody cares about the recovery. It's 1,600. So anyway, let's see what they have. All right. All right, so first skill, very useful. Crowd control monster. Very good for CC. It would be better if it was a stun because the petrification does give him more defense, but it's 100% chance, so I'm not going to complain at all. All right, so very good if you don't have a monster like a Shura, you need crit and all that. Just go ahead, bow. Petrification, 100% chance. Very good. Now, we have a seal on the active skill. Has a 70% chance. This is an AoE, so that's good. 70% chance AoE, I think is pretty good. And then we have those skill books coming later on too, so that it might even boost up to 100%. That would be pretty cool. All right, seal falls back and their skills do not activate. So I can see this one being useful in PvP, definitely in the arena. You don't want, say you come across a Shura, you don't want their passive skill to put you to sleep for 2 turns, all right? So very good, unit right here. I really like this one so far. Way better than the fire. Way better than the fire. Let's go ahead and look at the variant skill. Okay, turns like this. It turns white. I actually like the blue better, I think. Yeah, I like the blue better. But okay, I don't know. I don't. But the variant skill is very good though. It increases attack by power by 30 to 35%. So if you have, I would bring her on with a full on nuke team. And of course, hopefully all those units you bring in are have a high crit rate. That way you can just take advantage of that attack power. All right. So far, I think the water one's better. Let's go ahead and look at the tank. Wood Druidess. This is the Wood Bird. All right. So, okay. Way better HP because it is a tank, of course. 44,000. All right, attack is at way low though, 1800, and the defense is really low. So hopefully it looks like we have two debuff skills here. All right, 60% chance, not very good to me. Is that about the same as Kokomaru? Yeah, I think it's about the same as the 3-star Kokomaru, I think the fire one. But it's for 2 turns, that's cool. Hopefully we get skill books that could bring this up to 80, 90, to or 100. Hopefully we'll see. And so we got attack down for 2 turns. Attack down is always good, no matter where you are, Titans, PvP, or in the dungeon. So I would see people using her. And then also we have defense down. Defense down is also great, but it's also still kind of low to me, 60% chance. So I don't like how low it is, but I do like she has a lot of HP. She has a lot of HP, so. What's gonna happen is you're gonna stay alive long enough. Eventually, one of these debuffs are going to land. It's got to. Like, she's gonna stay alive. She's gonna be very tanky. All right, let's go ahead and go to the light one, all right? Oh, wait, variant skill. I don't know, I like the original way better than the variant, I think. Yeah, the variant. Anyway, all right, so let's go ahead and look at the light bird right here. All right, so we got the, 6-star Evo 3 Light Druidess. Let's see, her HP is at 33,740, so this is very good. We gotta already have the HP above the 30,000 mark for a balance type. I do like that. The attack is 2,400, so it's pretty comparable still to the wood one, I believe it was. No, was it the wood? No, the fire one. I believe the fire one had 2,500. And then the defense is lower though, because the fire one still had 2,500. But the defense lower is 21 and the recovery is 24. We don't really need the recovery. It would have been good if they could swap those two, but we can't really do too much about that. But let's go see what skills this one has. All right, so this one has critical hits siphons. All right, so it has to have a critical hit, so you have to hopefully get one with a square slot if you're gonna get her and you want to keep her in Evo 3 her. Hopefully you'll get one with a square slot, or it'll be a waste of a pull, I guess. That would suck. So anyway, critical hit siphon 30% of the enemy's SP. All right, so that's really good. It counters like the Dark Gatitos. It counters the Fire Siegfrieds and the Dark Monas and anybody else that can gain SP on their first skill and get ready to nuke you. So she is a good counter. You can use her in PvP. Mostly I think that's main place you could really use her as PvP, and also you could use her in dungeons to stop any of the monsters in the dungeons like when you get into the waves, or maybe it might even work on the boss. I don't know if the SP is gonna work on the boss. We're gonna have to find out, but if it does, it could stop them from using their active and probably wiping out your team, definitely, like even in dragons too. So, it depends on how good you make her. So, what else do we have? Attacks restore allies HP in amount equal to 10% of own HP. Nice. Alright. So, this one right here, what happens is, she already has a pretty good HP, 33,000 plus, right? You can get her to 70, 80, 100,000. What it's going to do is, every enemy she attacks, because she has an AoE, so let's say you had 100,000 HP. You're gonna heal for 40,000 HP because it's gonna be 10,000 per monster. Or if it's only 2 monsters, it's gonna be 20,000. So she's gonna be a very good healer that could spam that and stop the other person from using their active skill. So this is why I was looking at her like, I could see a lot of use for her. I like passive healers, so that way I don't have to really bring an active healer in. And I like when they have like another skill that's very useful, and this SP Siphon is very good. So hopefully if you get one, I would say keep her, and hopefully you get one with a square slot. So far, my favorite. This one right here. Let's check out the variant skill. All right, just the yellow is better. I'm not feeling her variants. I'm not. All right, and also that her leader skill is great if you bring nukers with her. So she'll keep them alive. She'll give y'all more attack boost. She'll give y'all attack power. I'm looking at her like, keep her. She's a keeper. Hopefully I get one with a square slot. Hopefully I even get one. First of all, so we'll see you tomorrow when this Hero Festival gets popping. All right, so now let's look at the last one. Let's look at the Dark Verd here. All right, so the Dark Verd, let's go ahead and Evo 3 it, because everybody's definitely going to be have the opportunity to Evo 3 it. And this one is an attacker. All right, so I think this is the only attacker we had out the bunch. Is it? We'll look again. I think it's the only attacker. Most of them been balanced, right? Haven't they? We had a tank, balance. All right, so we got this attacker here. All right, so attacker with 30,000 plus HP. So I don't know why they did the fire one like that. The fire one, y'all think y'all already know which one I think is the worst. Anyway, all right, 30,000 HP. The attack is 2,800. All right, so a little bit better, 300, like about 300 points better than all the other ones. The defense is real good still though, 25, and the recovery is low. So I'm already looking at her like these stats are really good. All right, so let's go ahead and go and see those skills. All right, already, you know what I'm thinking of? I'm thinking of Golem's B10. She has a sap on her first skill. Sap on her first skill. Grants 80% chance to inflict the target with three types of sap damage for one turn. Three types of sap damage for one turn. Wow. She will increase your runs. If anybody's having trouble with Golem's B10, this will be the one you want to get. This one right here. I think she will improve my run so much faster. The sap on that first skill is really strong. That's basically where I'm going to be using her if I get her. I think that's the one. All right. Grants an 80% chance to silence the enemies for one turn. Silence foes cannot use their active skill. So, all right. So, I don't know if you could use silence. I can't remember right now. I think you can use silence now on the golems. So, I'm thinking they just made her in mind to go and so you can farm quickly. And then PvP, I can see this skill. If you don't have somebody that can stop somebody from using their active skills, this could be very useful. She has an 80% chance to land it on the whole team, so it's very high. All right, so that's pretty, she's pretty strong. She has very good stats. She's an attacker, she has good HP for attacker, and she has SP damage for three turns, three types of sap damage for the first skill. Very good for B10. All right, so let's look at the variant. Okay, variant's a little, I don't know. It just seems more colorful when it's not variant. I don't know. This, it's all right, I guess. You would think this one would be the variant though. It just looks, it's popping more. But anyway, if I had to rank these verbs, I know off top, I gotta go with the light one. That's my number one. Where did I pass her? Where's my light bird? Okay, I gotta go with the light bird. She's balanced. I do like the SP Siphon, but she's a healer. All right, it's very close between the first one and my second one. My second one is dark. I could even almost switch them out, but I think I'm gonna go with the light as my favorite right now, if you have a square slot. And then dark will be my next favorite, the dark bird. Where is she at? She is the attacker, I believe, though. So yeah, the Dark Verd would be my next favorite. I can see anybody having trouble with B10. I think she'll make your runs a lot easier, and I would try to make her a big time damage dealer. Plus that sap on top of that will make those runs fast. And then after that, I would go with the water one. The water one's my next favorite. This Petrified, it's a crowd control monster. Gotta love the crowd control monsters, and they can stop you from you and your active as well on the whole team. All right, so she has a lot more uses to me than the other ones, and then the wood will be my. You already knew the fire one was like my least, right? I just don't understand why they did her like that. The wood, even though they're 60%, they're really low. She has very high HP. It gets to 40,000 plus, so she's gonna be landing these things eventually. And then I'm thinking it's gonna be a lot stronger with those skill books. And then last and least, I don't like this one at all, is the fire one, this blind and this courageous strike. I mean, I haven't really tried out any courageous striker. So if you really are into Titans, and that's all I can see her used for right now is Titans. That's it. But there's so many courageous strikers in the game that why fodder all your 4-star to get her? That's how I see it. So hopefully this was helpful to y'all. Which one y'all would want to keep? Hopefully if you like got one, you said, I don't know, should I keep this one? And you came across the video, hopefully this was helpful. But I just want to say thank y'all. The subscribers, man, it's increasing so quickly. I'm loving all the comments. I appreciate that so much. And if y'all like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, it's your boy, Sim Gamer, and I'm out.